I do not believe you are a racist. And I agree with you when you commit yourself to the importance of finding common ground.
With those words, Senator Kamala Harris confronting former Vice President Joe Biden and his long record on race in the most dramatic exchange in the first Democratic debate Thursday night in Miami.
There was a little girl in California who was part of the second class to integrate her public schools, and she was bused to school every day. And that little girl was me.
The fact is that in terms of busing, you would have been able to go to school the same exact way because it was a local decision made by your city council. That's fine. That's one of the things I argued for, that we should not be, we should be breaking down these lines.
Vice President Biden, do you agree today that you were wrong to oppose busing in America then?
No,
do you agree?
I did not oppose busing in America. What I opposed is busing ordered by the Department of Education.
That moment shining new light on a long ago chapter of Biden's life, from his earliest years in the Senate, when he strongly opposed mandatory school busing. It was designed to achieve integration and a more equitable education. It was the mid-1970s. Biden favored desegregation, but not through busing. What's less known is how he followed the lead of some of the Senate's most fervent segregationists. In a series of never-before-published letters reviewed by CNN, the strength of Biden's opposition to busing comes into sharper focus. On March 25, 1977, Biden wrote, "My bill strikes at the heart of the injustice of court-ordered busing. It prohibits the federal courts from disrupting our educational system." Biden sought and received support from Mississippi Senator James Eastland, the Democratic chairman of the Judiciary Committee and a leading symbol of Southern resistance to desegregation. He frequently spoke of blacks as, quote, an inferior race. Biden